Welcome to a lesson on combinations. The goals of this video are to evaluate a combination and also to use combinations to solve problems. A combination is a grouping or subset of items. So for a combination, the order does not matter. Remember, for a permutation, the order does matter. For example, if we want to know how many committees of three can be formed from a group of four students, this would be a combination because the order does not matter. And a combination can be written using three different types of notation, as we see here, here, and here. Let's go ahead and see if we can model this situation. Let's call the four students A, B, C, D. Let's see how many groups of three we can form using these four letters. Well, the first group might be A, B, C. And changing the order of these three will not create a new committee, which is the big difference between a combination and a permutation. Here, the order does not matter. So we could select ABD as another committee or subset. We could also use BCD. And the only other committee we could form would be ACD. So if we have four students and we want to form groups of three, there are only four possible outcomes. Let's take a look at a mathematical way of calculating a combination. A combination of n items taken r at a time can be denoted in three different ways, but it's equal to the permutation of n items taken r at a time divided by r factorial. What's happening here is we're taking the permutations, and then when we divide by r factorial, we're taking out the different orders of the subsets because the order no longer matters. And this is equal to n factorial divided by n minus r factorial times r factorial. Remember, the permutation of n items taken r at a time is equal to n factorial divided by n minus r factorial. And if we take this and divide by r factorial, this is what we end up with. So using the formula, let's go ahead and evaluate 7 choose 3. Our numerator would be 7 factorial. The denominator would be n minus r factorial, or 7 minus 3 factorial. And then r factorial, which would be 3 factorial. Let's go ahead and expand these. This would be 4 factorial, so we'd have 4, 3, 2, 1, and then 3 factorial. Of course, this simplifies. 4 factorial goes out with 4 factorial here. 3 times 2 would equal 6, so we can simplify these two factors with the 6. And we're left with 7 times 5 over 1, which is equal to 35 combinations. For the second example, we would have 15 factorial. Our denominator would be, well, n minus r would be 10, so we have 10 factorial, and then r would be 5, so we have 5 factorial. Now let's go ahead and evaluate this one on the calculator. We can evaluate a combination in this form with a graphing calculator, but it would probably help if we wrote it in this notation here. So this would be 15 choose 5. And the reason I say that is to use the calculator, we first type in n, which is 15, press math, go over to the probability menu, select option 3 for a combination, and then type in r, which is 5. This comes out to 3003. So we have 3003 combinations if we have 15 items and we choose 5 at a time. And just to verify this, let's go ahead and evaluate it in factorial form as well. So we have 15 factorial, math, probability, option 4, divided by 10 factorial times 5 factorial. And the value is the same as expected. Let's go and take a look at some problems now. The soccer team has 20 players. There are always 11 players on the field. How many different groups of players can be on the field at any one time? So we're not considering their positions, so the order does not matter. Therefore, this is a combination. So we have a combination of 20 players taken 11 at a time. We can write it like this, or even like this. So this would be equal to 20 factorial divided by 20 minus 11 factorial, that would be 9 factorial, and then r factorial, which is 11 factorial. Now again, we could do this by hand, but I'm going to go ahead and use the calculator due to time. And I will use the combination feature of the calculator, so we'll press 20 math, probability, option 3, and then press R, which is 11. Enter. So we have 167,960 possible combinations of players on the field. Here, a student needs 8 more classes to complete her degree. If she has met the prerequisites for all of the courses, how many ways can she take 4 classes next semester? Again, the order does not matter. Therefore, this would be a combination of 8 items chosen 4 at a time. Let's go ahead and do this one by hand. So we would have 8 factorial. Our denominator would be 8 minus 4 factorial. That's 4 factorial. And then R factorial, which is also 4 factorial. So we'd have 8 times 7 times 6 times 5. I'm going to stop here and write 4 factorial. And for the denominator, we'll have 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 times this factorial as well. That saves a little bit of writing because the 4 factorials simplify out. Let's see what else we can do. Well, here's a factor of 4 and 2. That would be 8, so we can simplify those. And we're left with a 3. Well, here's a 6, so we can simplify the 3 out and change the 6 to a 2. So we have 7 times 2 times 5, which is equal to 70. So given 8 classes, there are 70 ways that she can choose 4 of them. Let's go ahead and verify this with the calculator. So we'll have 8 choose 4. Option 3, press 4 for R, and there we go. Let's take a look at one more. There are 4 men and 5 women in a small office. The customer wants a site visit from a group of 2 men and 2 women. How many different groups can be formed from the office? Well, again, the order doesn't matter because we're forming groups. But there are really 2 events going on here. We have to select or choose the men, and then we also have to choose or select the women. So we're going to find the number of ways that we can select the men, and we're going to multiply it by the number of ways that we can select the women. So we'll first consider the number of ways that we can choose the men. Well, there are 4 men and we're choosing 2 at a time. So that would be 4 choose 2. And then for the women, there's 5 to choose from. So this would be times 5 choose 2. So let's go ahead and write this out. We'd have 4 factorial over 4 minus 2 factorial. That's 2 factorial. Then another 2 factorial for R times, here we'd have 5 factorial over 5 minus 2 factorial. That's 3 factorial times 2 factorial. So there's our numerator, and our denominator would look like this. Now let's simplify. Well, here's a 2 times a 2. That would simplify with a 4. Here we have 3 times 2 times 1. That would simplify here and here. And then lastly, we have this factor of 2, which would simplify with this 4. That would change to 1. That would change to a 2. So it looks like we have 6 times 10, which is equal to 60. So they could form 60 different groups of 2 men and 2 women from 4 men and 5 women for the site visit. Okay, thank you for watching, and I hope you found this helpful.